Introduction, thermal inertia of unsaturated soil. Thermal inertia P is one of the parameters used to characterize the thermal properties of soil and is defined as the square root of the product of the volumetric heat capacity C and thermal conductivity lambda, which is given as. Thermal inertia appears in the formulation of the ground heat flux when it is formulated with a unique variable known as the land surface temperature, LSD, and one does not have to consider the vertical profile of the soil temperature. In terms of the relation between soil thermal properties and soil moisture, both the volumetric heat capacity C, which is the product of specific heat C and the bulk density rho of the soil, and the thermal conductivity lambda increase as the soil moisture increases. Accordingly, thermal inertia P also increases as soil moisture increases. Therefore, soil moisture can be estimated inversely if the thermal inertia value is known. The volumetric heat capacity is a moderate linear function of soil moisture. By contrast, thermal conductivity has a strong nonlinearity with soil moisture, making it difficult to parameterize thermal conductivity and hence thermal inertia. Schematic of the relationship between volumetric heat capacity, thermal conductivity, and thermal inertia in terms of soil moisture. Thermal inertia is effective when the time series of the surface temperature is available, but the vertical profile of the soil temperature is not available. The differential equation for heat diffusion is given as, where Tzt is the soil temperature at depth Z and time T, which is the difference from a constant value at an infinite depth. This equation is solved to reproduce the daily and yearly periodic cycles of soil temperature, under the boundary conditions that the temperature change is sinusoidal at the surface and constant at an infinite depth. The basic solution is as follows using the complex number expression. 3, is rewritten as follows using the real number expression. The conductive heat flux in soil at depth Z and time T, Gzt, is defined as where the vertical profile of soil temperature is obviously required to calculate the soil heat flux. However, when the soil temperature solution, 3, or 5, is applied to the soil heat flux, 6, and then Z is set to 0, it only uses the time series of surface temperature as follows. In deriving, 7, the following relation derived from, 3. The above derivation describes thermal inertia being effective for quantifying soil thermal properties when only the LSD is known, which leads to the analysis of the land surface processes using satellite LSDs. The above procedure leads to the studies proposed by Matsushima and co-researchers, which are described in Section 2. Considerable effort has been made to estimate the thermal inertia of the Earth's surface mainly using LSD data from satellites. Most of this effort has been concentrated on retrieving daily values of thermal inertia due to the availability of daily maximum and minimum LSDs observed from polar orbiting or geostationary satellites. Models using these types of satellite LSDs are based on the Earth's surface energy balance principle, which includes not only the radiation budget but also turbulent heat flux. A Fourier series expansion was introduced to solve, 1. Under the above Earth's surface boundary conditions using the solution of the real number expression, 5. Models have been improved from those using only the two daily extreme LSDs to those using LSDs that are irrespective of time and a diurnal change and other significant studies that follow a series of important proposals by Shui and Cracknell, which are also described in Section 2 when compared with studies by Matsushima and co-researchers. This lecture reviews former and state-of-the-art methods for estimating soil moisture by exploring the relationship between thermal inertia and soil moisture. Section 2 reviews past developments of methods for thermal inertia retrieval from land surface models. Section 3 describes how thermal inertia is experimentally observed, and how it is retrieved from land surface models in terms of the Shui and Cracknell-based models and the Matsushima models. Section 4 describes several semi-empirical parameterizations of thermal inertia in terms of soil moisture. Section 5 describes applications of thermal inertia for analyzing hydrometeorological phenomena around the Earth's surface and also discusses further exploration of thermal inertia itself and its applications. Section 6 presents conclusions.